All right, Shalom, Shalom, Yah Shirala. Back at it again with another Lord with an edifying video through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Rachakodash. Before going any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Rachakodash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders, the great millstone, who still guard us their highways and byways and feed us with 100% true, according to the Bible, in Heruel, in Shalom, Lavacharium, Wabarakim, Shayah Shirala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel, and the Lashon Kodash, the Hebrew tongue. And it's pretty much going to be, you know, a lesson centered around repentance, man. You know, now we know 2/3 of our people, of our nation, of these so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, and also the Israelite foreigners, are not going to repent. Okay, you see, but that's why we're calling the elect of the nation of Israel to repentance, right? And we're condemning the 2/3 of our people. So this is the book of Second Esdras 16, let's see, 16, what is it, 67. This is the book of Second Esdras 16, verse 67. Behold, which means to look. Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah himself is the judge. Fear him, right? Because when you read in the same book, in the book of Ecclesiasticus or Sirach, the first chapter, it explains that the fear of the Lord is the beginning or root of wisdom, you know, which is the knowledge of wisdom and understanding of the Bible. And it says, leave off from your sins and forget your iniquities, right? Meaning repent, man. That's how you leave off from your sins. How do you leave off from your sins? What's that? Psalms 119 verse 109. Wherewithal shall a young man clean his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word, man. You see? So by sticking to the scriptures, man, sticking what the scripture says to do to the best of our abilities, man. Can we break down that word repent? Re meaning back, pent meaning to regret or make sorry, man. So all the things that we was doing in the world, man, you see, we're supposed to regret what we did, and by us being in this truth, we're supposed to stay away from those things, you know, through the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, and you know, conduct ourselves as Lord Yahweh Shai wanted us to conduct ourselves. So this is the book of Sirach. This is the book of Second Esdras 16 verse 67. Behold, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai himself is the judge. Fear him. Leave off from your sins. What sin is a transgression of the law. You know, when you read 1 John 3 and 4, and it says, which is only given to the nation of Israel, by the way, and forget your iniquities, which is sin upon sin, and meddle no more with them forever. Exactly, see? So, hey, don't do the things that you used to do. You know, like smoking weed, smoking cigarettes, getting tattoos, sleeping with another man's wife, you see, doing certain things, you know what I'm saying, on the Sabbath, you know, to the best of your abilities to try to prevent, you see. And it see, and it reads, so Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah leads you forth and deliver you from all trouble. Exactly. He's gonna deliver us from Jacob's trouble. Lord's willing to be at the elect, start the head apostle, elders of great millstone. And he's ultimately going to deliver us from the destruction that he's bringing with those missiles, man. And from the chariots with the word going to cause UFOs. That's only a promise to the elect of deliverance, you see, from the destruction. Because the elect of the nation of Israel is going to be the only one that's going to sincerely repent and endure to the end and finish the Lord's work. I pray we be a part of that number, starting with what I hear apostles on down. So now we're going to go to the book of Acts, the 3rd chapter, and 19th verse. And it says, repent ye therefore, and be converted. But when you break down the word convert, con meaning with, pervert meaning truth. So, first to feel sorry, you know what I'm saying, for what you did, and be transformed with by the truth. By the wisdom and knowledge and understanding of the scriptures, which has to be taught to you through men that Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah set up, aka the prophets, right? Starting off with the head apostles and elders on down. And it says that your sins may be blotted out. Yep. And the only sins that's going to be blotted out of the nation of Israel is the elect. And it says, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Exactly. See, that time of refreshing is that time of destruction, that fire, man. You see? And the only ones that's going to be destroyed, you know what I'm saying, is the two-thirds, man. Because the scripture says in Malachi, the third chapter, it said, I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. You see? You know? Even Amos 9 and 8, but he shall be saved out of it. That's talking about the elect and the rest of the one-third, man. You see? You know? And you could tie that in with Isaiah 66, verse 15. So, hey, to the best of our ability, you know, start talking to myself first and foremost. Make sure, you know, we're praying for forgiveness, you know, that we're repenting day by day, you know. So this is the book of, let's see, 2 Peter 3, verse 8. 2 Peter 3, verse 8. But beloved, now the beloved of the Lord is the house of David, the elect. And it says, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. So one day to us, I mean, for for 1,000 years to us is one day with the Lord. You see? You know? Just like when you read Genesis, the first chapter, you see, you know, it says, well, in the evening, in the morning, with the first day, you know what I'm saying? To us, that would be 1,000 years. But to the Lord, that's one day. You see? So the slavery and the horrific things that happen to our people as a nation, you know what I'm saying? To us, it's a long time ago, but to the Lord, it's like yesterday. You see, that's why the Lord is going to come back and recompense all the things that happened to our nation, man. All the 12 tribes. And it says, verse 9, for the Lord is not slack concerning his promise. His promise, one of them is salvation of the elect. And another promise is the destruction of Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, man. You know? And having these other heathen nations, beginner of their elites in the slavery and subjection, and establish righteousness in the planet Earth underneath Lord Yahweh Shah and King David. And it reads, as some count slackness, but as long suffering to us were, right, being to Israel, and not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. That's referring to the elect. All of the elect, because all of the Israelites, you know what I'm saying, of our people, are not going to repent, man. You see? So the only one that the Lord is calling forth to repentance, you see, and deliverance is the elect. You know, that's what it's all about. That's why the elder apostles always say it's all about the elect, the elect, the elect, which the word elect means chosen. Those who's chosen, you know, predestined to endure to the end, to resist the mark of the beast, which is the RFID microchip, that's our temptation, you know, die for the Lord if they have to, some of them will, and be saved when the Lord Yahweh Shah comes back, when the Heavenly Father gives Yahweh Shah to go. You see? So that's what it's all about, man. It's all about the elect. It ain't all about all of our nation, man. So let's go into the book of Matthew. Let's see what John the Baptist was preaching, right? Let me see. This is the book of Matthew. What is it? Third chapter, I believe. Yep, this is the book of Matthew 3, verse 1. And it says, in those days came John the Baptist teaching in the wilderness of Judea. Now, John the Baptist is the cousin of Lord Yahweh Shai, right? And it says, you can read about that in Luke. And it says, verse 2, and saying, repent ye, he was talking to the Israelites, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Exactly, see? So repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, man. And the kingdom of heaven starts with this knowledge. You see, this truth, you know, which is only going to be given to us a few men, the elect, which we're hoping to be, man. You see, you know, and then we're going to establish order. Lord Yahweh Shah, when he returns, is going to establish order on the earth, man. You see, so we're telling the elect to repent, be ready for what Lord Yahweh Shah's return, and we'd be delivered out of here. Out of captivity, Lord's will, you know, for doing the work of the Lord, for being patient, for enduring the hour of temptation, you know, just obeying and staying in order to the best of our abilities, man. That's the characteristics of the elect. As a matter of fact, I'm going to draw to verse 7. And it says, matter of fact, verse 6, and they were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generations of vipers, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Exactly, see? So John the Baptist is like, hey, man, listen, man. Y'all already know what y'all doing. Y'all wicked. You see what I'm saying? You know, hey, you know, you might as well go ahead and just get prepared for the destruction. That's the same mindset we have to our people to this day. If we see that somebody can't get it, we know that they wicked of our people, we tell them to go up the street and get ready to be destroyed, man. Verse 8, bring therefore fruits meet or worthy of repentance, man, which is the elect. You see? So Lord's willing, that was edifying. Till next time, I say shalom.